Because see, we have this propensity as people to define God, define our faith, define creation through our own lens, through our own ideas of how we think it should be or how we want it to be, and not how it will be. Will he come for his bride? Oh, yes, he will. And will he come to set up his kingdom? Oh, yes, he will. Even Yeshua himself said the kingdom of God is near. What could be more near than right here? What could be more near? So the kingdom is here, but the kingdom is coming as well. And again, we try to understand that within our own filters and ways of defining things. But it's true. It's how God wishes to do things, because no longer does he need the flesh. He has been delivered from the flesh as we should be delivered from the flesh through his atoning work. It's what we will be looking at in Passover, the sacrifice that he made. Let us not sacrifice him any longer. He has released us. So let us live not at what was, but let us live for what is to be. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Brother?
Shabbat shalom.
You may be seated. We have some busy time coming up for us in the next few weeks, starting with today, immediately following Onik, as we'll be having our Beit Midrash class, so those that are involved with that, continue to come and be a part and to worship together and study together and discuss and open the Word and dig deeper. 1 week from today, we will be celebrating Purim. Realize that Purim is not a mandated holiday in the Bible, but it is referenced in the Bible as something that was a celebration, a time of remembrance. And so we will be doing that next week. One of the things that is common in that celebration traditionally, and when we talk about tradition, this becomes just a very personal thing. It's what you see as being appropriate, as how God would have you worship in at any of our celebrations when we talk about tradition. So one of the traditions in the Purim celebration is to, in reading the book of Esther, because that is the whole purpose of Purim, the celebration, the remembrance. Read the book of Esther, and there are a number of characters that are within that book, within that writing. And so those are some of the things that people will dress accordingly to characterize one of those people. So that's what I would encourage you. It's not a time when we dress up in whatever we want to. Although some celebrations, if you look at them, they get kind of rowdy and totally unbiblical. But what I would encourage you is, if you want to dress of the era, or particularly one of the characters that we find in the book of Esther, we would welcome you to come dressed as some of these people. And there are both sides. There are the good and the evil. So you can choose which one that you would like to dress and dress accordingly. But we will be celebrating that next week during our regular Shabbat service. Not very far behind that is our celebration of Pesach. We will be celebrating on Sunday, the 9th of April. And if you go and look at your Bible and read the dates and everything else, you'll say, well, that's one day early. Well, yes, it is, because Pesach actually begins at sundown on Monday, according to all the calendars. However, Sunday is an appropriate time for us because we can have I hate to say this, do it for convenience, but it is an opportunity that we can have to share the whole celebration of Pesach with a larger number of people. And therefore, we'll be celebrating on Sunday evening. I have a sign-up list here. We would like to have a fairly accurate count of those that will be attending on that celebration. This list has a bunch of names on it already with numbers. However, this is just because that's what it was last year. Okay, so I need this, and this will be during Onik. This tablet will be out there. I need you to initial. Look at the number that are there for your name, and please initial that number is valid or corrected to what it will be for this year. The cost of our celebration this year is $10 per person, $15 for a couple, and children 12 and under are free. However, bear this in mind, no one will be turned away. This is an open celebration, and therefore, if cost is a problem, there are others that will help cover that cost, because we have a very generous congregation, Mishpachah. And while we're talking about the generosity of our Mishpachah, February being the shortest month of the year, it was one of our best financially this past February. So thank you to each one of you for continuing to support and to lift us up financially. It sure helps. So our thanks to them. Also, as we're talking about Pesach, one more thing to bear in mind. This is a time that we really are opening up to the public and to people who ordinarily may not be a part of our congregation, someone that may be coming to investigate, to look at what is Pesach all about. So in that process, we would like to have our facility looking festive and being ready to accommodate. We are anticipating this year probably somewhere in the neighborhood of 150 people. So to do that, it takes preparation. Last Shabbat, we had a time of fellowship where we talked about some of the preparation things that we're going to be doing, and people accepted some responsibilities to prepare for that. But one of the things that we're going to do is we're going to have a mitzvot Shabbat on the Saturday immediately before. So on the 8th, following services, following Onig, we are going to rearrange everything within this confine here to make it ready for the celebration of Pesach. And there is some heavy lifting, some moving around of furniture, so those that can help us to stick around on that day following our Onig, we'll call it a mitzvot Shabbat. Because it is preparation for service, it is something that we are doing to honor our God. And therefore, it is not considered work, it is considered a part of our fellowship and a part of our worship. So bear that in mind also. If you were not here last Shabbat and you want to help in any way with food or with some of that preparation, if you talk to Rochelle, she will help you out and give you some assignments. So she's good at that. She's good at telling people what to do and where to go. But we appreciate that. Appreciate that very, very much. So again, let me just remind you, this listing will be circulated during Onik today. And if you're not staying for Onik, please take a look at it before you go. To initial, put your initials over on the right-hand side. That confirms that number. If the number on here is not right, please change it. If your name is not on this list and you're going to be here, please add it to it. And I would appreciate that very much. The closer we can get to an accurate count, the easier it is to plan. Because it's kind of tough to start setting up tables and setting place settings and setting up other plates at the last minute. So we appreciate that.
Also, is it preparation by invitation?
Yes.
Now is the time to start inviting. Amen? What a wonderful opportunity to lead both Jewish brothers and sisters into understanding of their Jewish Messiah, and for the Christian brothers and sisters to lead them into the truth of their word and not the traditions that have buried them. Amen?
Amen. We've had some conversation in the past, and we start talking about tradition, things that we do just because it's tradition, and why do we do it. And this is a good time to start discussing with other people as you come into it, and you talk about you're celebrating Pesach, and they say, well, we're celebrating Easter, they're the same thing, aren't they? Well, this is a good time to get into traditional type things, because the celebration of Easter and all that has come to the Christian church is all strictly tradition. Okay, and as we are celebrating Pesach, there are a lot of things that we have done that are also just strictly tradition. This year's celebration of Pesach may be just a little bit different to you, because our pastor is, and our rabbi is going to try to bring it back more to the biblical definition of Pesach and how Pesach would have been celebrated, as opposed to some of the traditional things that have been thrown in to that worship and celebration. So it might be a little different. You say, well, it's the same thing it was last year, so I don't really need to go this year. I think this is the one you really need to come to, because this one is going to be more on the biblical definition of what Pesach is all about and how it's celebrated. So as he has said, now is the time to those people that talk to you and say, why do you do what you do? Well, come on along, let me show you why we do what we do. It's a good time to bring them into.
If nothing else, brother, they might be curious to see what the First Communion was all about, since most Christian churches celebrate communion.
And again, this is something that communion has become a tradition in the church and in a lot of places. Come find out what the basis of that is. And this is a good talking point when someone says, well, what is communion? What is Pesach all about? Well, you celebrate communion. Come on and see what that's all about. So here's a good opportunity to come and share. Another opportunity to share is when we bless our young children. They are not only our congregation of today and the future, but we are instructed to teach them diligently, to bless them and to protect them, to raise them up in the ways that God would have them raised up. So children 12 and under, please come forward. Let us have the opportunity to bless you as we are directed.
As they're coming forward, they even want to let a little note. This is actually a third anniversary of my wife coming to this congregation. This is the first service 3 years ago.
Also, as we talk about anniversary and celebration, the portion today, if you go back to when Daniel did his bar mitzvah, this is the portion that Daniel used for his bar mitzvah. So we are returning and honoring that today.
Simcha Elohim Kehefrahim Vachem Nashe. May Yahweh make you as Ephraim and Manashe. Yisameach Elohim Kasarah, Rivka, Rachel, Leah, Vimiriam. May Yahweh make you as Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, Leah, and Miriam. Hashem Yeshua, Adonai, and the congregation says,
Amen.
Amen. Children, you may be dismissed.